Hey guys, it's @Soylicious here.
And Chelsea Ricotto with two A's.
Today we are going to be reviewing the Kylie birthday kits. Yay! Don't be showing my address, you crazy!
Nobody can see your address.
They be zooming in and stuff, you out of your mind.
But there's the light though.
All right, so we're going to be reviewing the Poppin' Birthday Goss
and Leo.
Yay!
Oh, we got both each?
Yeah.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah.
Come up.
Right. So.
Well, first, the box is really cute.
Yeah.
I love it. I love the gold.
Here's the little letter. It says, "It's my birthday. I want to do something special for you guys to help me celebrate. This has been an amazing year because of my love for you. Have shown me in Kylie Cosmetics. XO Kylie."
Aw, thank you, Kylie.
We have made you a millionaire while we stay broke.
Thanks. For nothing! Except for really great looking lips. This color is going to slay this fall. It's completely. Now, of course, it comes with the lip liner. If you are familiar with Kylie Cosmetics, you know about this. It's life.
This lip liner is so creamy. Like, I don't even know. Like, what is this? This is crack.
Perfect.
Look at this gold packaging. Hi. It should all come like this.
And this is the matte one, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Matte. I'm obsessed with matte. Court K, everything. This fall as well. What else is it? There's a dark one too.
It should all come gold like this. Just saying.
Just saying, like Kylie. This. Go on ahead and just change the packaging.
Just change it all gold.
Because the other one's so... This past summer.
I mean, you know, black, like, everything's black. Like, gold gay.
Squad. Right. So. All right, so we're going to go ahead and try this.
Here we go.
Review it. So look at right here. Of course, perfect. Everything, the shape, nice for lining. And I know that there was a big, like, controversy. Nobody knew if it actually sharpened or not, but it actually does. Just sharpen it.
Kind of hard to sharpen though. You do have to like push it up against and like actually like, but it does sharpen.
But you will notice how soft it sharpens.
Yeah.
Yeah. Completely. This color should go with everything, but here we go. All right.
It is very soft.
This has improved so much since the first kit actually. Mm-hmm. Completely. So if you're like me, you kind of shade more a little bit on the outside. I notice a lot more people have been actually doing that, just shading a little bit more with the liner and then putting the lip gloss on top of it or the lipstick on top of it. Whatever way you do it, it probably works more, but I definitely like to do the shading because it does bring more color and it has more effect to it.
Yeah, and then I shade more in the middle of my lips just so the lipstick actually stays in the middle of my lips because I'm always like when I'm like out, so. So that went really well for me. And then now
I have to make sure I get inside
yeah.
of my lip too.
Yeah.
Because the last thing I need.
So this is my brush.
So this is really, this lip liner is very, very, very similar to Court K actually. I want to just throw that out there, but.
This smells like vanilla, like the other ones. Here's the brush.
This smell. It's not all tacky.
Yeah.
The glosses for me, the head and the brushes is just ridiculous. But yeah, mine, same thing. So let me go ahead and put this on for you.
Oh my God.
Do you love? Oh yes, I already know this is gonna be my color. Okay, so this is just one coating. So if your lips are like mine, well, if your lips like anybody, or if you're like me, you have to definitely do more than one coat. So I would highly suggest shading your whole lip with a liner before you actually put the lipstick on.
Definitely.
That's going to be like my biggest
suggestion. This is one coat. Let me get up close for you guys so you can see. This is one coat. It's one coat, guys. But it's very full-bodied.
It's a very good color. That's a good color on you, actually. Yeah,
it's very full-bodied.
So, I mean, it kind of does look like it's very familiar to Court K, especially on my skin tone. So, I can definitely see the difference on Soy's skin tone. But for me, I feel like it does come... Oh, it's very similar to Court K.
And it's actually, as it's drying...
It's very nice.
It's very nice. It's not as drying as the other formulas.
Make sure you do. Make sure you moisturize your lips the night before. Oh, make sure you don't have any lipstick or, I mean, not lipstick, chapstick or anything like that before you put this on, because you will walk around with a whole bunch of little crust coming off, little colored crust coming off.
It'll flake.
You don't want Leo flakes. Nobody wants Leo flakes. Well, let me go on ahead and put a second coat on, and then I'll let you guys be the judge of that.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and hook you up.
So I think that it's really nice. It seems like there's a lot in the two.
Yeah, I'm scraping the sides, and there's no, it's not going away. So it's actually a full tube. We're not getting gypped.
All right, I like it. I like it. I like it a lot.
Yes, I like this. I like that it's not like my True Brown K, as you guys seen in my other videos, is very drying. Like it's like chalk. This is like drying, but it's not like the Sierra Nevada. Like, it's not like... This is, like, actually, like...
I can't wait to try brown sugar, though.
Oh, that looks like the perfect nude for us. Like, thank you for thinking of us.
I appreciate you, Kylie. And you know who else I appreciate? Jordan. Because if it wasn't for Jordan, that color probably wouldn't even have been existed. You're the real MVP.
Yeah, like, thank you for being the black friend.
Or the mixed friend. Whatever you want to call it. But seriously, though... Brown sugar, you're next. But for now, this is what it looks like on me.
Let me do a swatch on my hand.
So this is actually a really good color for like my skin tone, everything. Like I had mentioned, it does make me feel like it has a lot of similarities to Court K. Court K is a little bit more darker. This is a bit more subtle, but I actually really like this color. If I were to choose one of them, I'd probably make this one my everyday fall shade. But between this and then brown sugar, I anticipate will be my new color for fall. But this one looks really, really good. It has more of a brown effect on you, I feel like.
Yeah, this one's a little bit more brown undertone.
And this one's a little
more plum on her.
Yeah, plummy, burgundy, whatever you want to call it. But it doesn't matter because...
It looks good on both of us.
It looks really good.
This is the swatch on me.
So I'll do the swatch myself too then.
So you can kind of tell a little bit more.
Ooh, the swatch looks good on my skin.
Yeah, the swatch looks really good.
So there's like my swatch, and then I'll do the lip liner on the bottom.
And then as you can see, it's not like overpowering.
Yeah, so that's the swatch on both of us.
And we are not the same skin tone. Just thought we'd point that out. Kind of looks like we are, but we're not.
You have a much skinnier wrist than me. I think that's hot. So, yes, I like the color. I enjoy it. I have plenty of burgundy turtle tops turtlenecks that will actually go with this.
I think this will go good with grays as well.
Yeah, very well with gray, actually. I mean, once you get that fall color in your hair.
I mean, I have gray hair right now.
Get like a nice sandy brown kind of thing going on, or like a leaf auburn kind of color. You'll be good.
It's a little sticky right now. I think it's drying a little bit though, but it's a little sticky.
Mine's actually dry. I put two coats on. This is two coats, and I feel like it's actually suffice.
Mine's two coats. Mine's a little sticky. I don't know. Maybe.
Yeah, mine is absolutely suffice. Mine's actually really, really good.
I don't know.
If you want to ask me.
But
this is the eyeshadow that I have on with this. It goes really well. This is my everyday eyeshadow by Anastasia. Anastasia. Sorry. Excuse my accent. But it's called Camel, if you are interested. I think that it's a very good color. It goes very well with this, but there's also, you know, other colors that will go with it as well.
This is the, once again, this is the Kylie Birthday Leo.
Leo. Liquid matte, baby. Kylie, you are the real MVP for that. I don't care what anybody says. I don't care about ColourPop. I am about this. I've always been about it.
And even though ColourPop supposedly makes her stuff, I like this.
If that's the case, then geez, whatever. Call me a label whore, because I'm all about it.
I mean, yeah, we always have been, so.
But between this and, is it Unicorn Blood with Jeffree Star?
Amaze. First of all, for Jeffree Star, just in general.
Why?
I'm not going to buy Jeffree Star stuff.
Why not? The highlighter is everything, that vampire skin and unicorn.
That's another video for another day.
This is good. And another one similar like it, Unicorn Blood. But you make the pick and the decisions.
So if you guys like this video or if you guys have tried this out, comment, let us know. Give us gold hearts,
please. And thank you.
You know,
because you're a gold heart and a firework, damn it.
Yes. So comment, like, subscribe, and let us know.
Thank you, darling.
And check out the next video for the poppin' lip gloss.
Poppin' gloss for your poppin' ass.
With your poppin' lips. All right.
And your poppin' life. Bye. Bye.